There have been many examples of me being scatterbrained, but listen to what I did before we boarded on a plane. We left on a Friday night, was traveling by air. It was a trip to Edmonton, my sister was up there. I had the gear all packed up for the 2 weeks we'd be gone. I locked the door and hid the key from my young fella John. To mind the house when I was away, and so I locked the doors. Forgot I left the tray of Capelin on the basement floor. A few days later John came in and noticed something off. A smell was in the air inside the house, it made him cough. He left the windows open, and then when he checked back in a few days, the smell that was in the house was worsening. In fact, when he pulled in the driveway and got out of the car, the maple trees outside the windows he had left ajar were falling down as if to say, I can't take this no more. Someone must have left the tray of Capelin on the basement floor. So he went in the back door, and when he went inside, the smell that was in there before was 10 times amplified. Plants were almost to the door, the flower pots they dragged across the floor, but it was buckled up and all the carpet shagged. Bulbs were melted from the pot, lights hanging from the ceiling. Pictures falling off the walls, all the paint was peeling. When he went down over the stairs and started to explore, he found there was a tray of Capelin on the basement floor. So he went in the room and started to evaluate. He was responsible for this and he couldn't wait. Should he remove the tray somehow and wipe the basement floor down? Or should he leave it where it is to get out and beat it out of town? Scooping up the tray, it wasn't so easy as it sounds. There were several hundred flies buzzing all around. Johnny, by God loving, the flies he did ignore. Attracted to the tray of Capelin on the basement floor. From this point on, the story's too disgusting to repeat, but now I'm not the most beloved person living on this street. We'll never know how Johnny got that Capelin out of the house. He must have covered his face and held his breath because it was some Fausty. And in any case, the house, it didn't rot and crumble down, although it is one of the most avoided ones in town. Every second day, the house is lathered up and rinsed, and has been wrapped in plastic and tarpaulin ever since. Nobody's gonna buy it, now I'm stuck with this chore, because there was a tray of Capelin on the basement floor.